Welcome back. In today's video, I'll be showing you how to fix microphone problems on a Windows 11 PC or laptop. I'll be covering methods that could help fix a variety of mic problems, such as sound or connection issues. Remember to leave a like and feel free to subscribe if the video helps. Let's get into the methods. We'll start by checking the connection of the microphone. Check the physical connection, and if you can, try another port on your device. If your microphone uses USB, try as many ports as you can on your PC. If you have a desktop, there should be plenty of ports on the back to try. If your microphone uses the 3.5mm connector, make sure it is connected to the microphone port and not the headphone port. Whichever port you use, check that the connections aren't broken and that it is fully inserted into the port. The next thing to do is to try your microphone on another device if you can, such as a different PC or laptop. This will help rule out that the issue is with the microphone itself. If your microphone doesn't work on a separate device, it's likely that there is physical damage. If your microphone works normally on your other device, then the problem is likely caused by something within Windows, so that's what we'll focus on next. We'll now move on to some fixes within Windows. These methods will help make sure the microphone is working normally and should help fix problems that relate to the mic not being detected properly or sound problems with the microphone. First, we'll check that the mic is enabled and allowed. I'll show you two different ways to do this. First, head to the main settings page. You can get there a number of ways, but we'll be searching for it in the search bar. In the settings, go to the system settings from the options on the left, although you should be already in here by default. In the system settings, click on the option called sound. Within the sound settings, find the section called input. Under this, it should say something like, choose a device for speaking or recording. Below this, you should see the list of microphones or sound input devices connected to your PC. If you have multiple, select the one you want to use by checking the box to the left of its name. If you don't see your device here, scroll down and click on All Sound Devices. Now find your device from the Input section, click on it, and then choose Allow on the next page. It should now appear back in the Input section of the main Sound Settings page, and you can set it as default by checking the box to the left of it. The second way to do this is if you click on More Sound Settings, which is in the main Sound Settings page that we were just on. In the new window, first go to the Recording tab. You should see all of the microphones and other input devices in here. If you don't see your device, right-click on an option and choose Show Disabled and Show Disconnected Devices. To enable your microphone in here, right-click on it and then click on Enable. You can set it as the default sound input device in here too, with the button at the bottom of the window. Next, we'll try re-enabling the device, updating drivers, and then reinstalling the device. To do this, search for Device Manager in the search bar and open it. Within here, look for the section called Audio Inputs and Outputs and expand it by double-clicking on it. Now double-click on your microphone if you see it. If you don't see it, try looking in the Sound, Video and Game Controllers section or the Bluetooth section. In the new window that opens, go to the Driver tab. First, select Disable in here and then wait a few moments and then select Enable. Try your microphone again now. Next, click on Update Driver and then the Automatic option. If there are already the correct drivers installed, you can close this box. The third thing to try in here is to choose Uninstall Device and then Uninstall. Now go to where it says Action at the top and select Scan for Hardware Changes. Try your microphone once again now to see if this helped. If your microphone doesn't appear back in here, disconnect it from your PC and reconnect it. Next, a simple system restart could help if you haven't done this already. A restart could help refresh a lot of the settings on your PC and it could help fix the problem. It's up to you if you want to try this now or at the end of the video, but if you do restart now, when you return to the video, we'll have a few more solutions to try. We'll now try checking the microphone access or permissions in Windows. Search for microphone privacy settings in the search bar and open the link. Within here, make sure microphone access is turned on at the top. Now make sure that Let Apps Access Your Microphone is also turned on. Finally, have a look down the list and look for the apps you use your microphone in. Make sure the toggle switch is turned on next to each of these apps. Now think back to when the issue started appearing. There is a chance that a software change or hardware change caused the problem. This could be some new audio software or a new component. If you are certain that one of these changes caused the problem, then you could revert them or research how this will have affected your device and what you can do to work around it. If your microphone doesn't work in certain apps but does in others, this would most likely indicate that the settings in the app itself aren't set up correctly for your microphone. Have a look in the sound or audio settings to see if you can set it to use your microphone. The final thing I'd recommend is to check your manufacturer's website for more information. For example, your microphone may need a certain setup process or drivers to work properly. Your mic may also need extra hardware, such as a power supply, in order to operate. Unfortunately, those are all of the methods I have. As always, I will keep the description updated with any new solutions I find, and if any of you find a fix in the future, then it would be great if you could return to the video and post it in the comments to help others. Click the card on screen now to watch a video of mine showing you 10 easy ways to speed up your Windows PC. If you have any questions, then let me know in the comments below, and if you did find today's video helpful, remember to leave a like, and feel free to subscribe for more tips in the future. Be sure to stick around to see some of my other videos that you might be interested in. Thanks so much for watching, and I will see you in another video.